Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action, sanctioned by the NWA, National Wrestling Alliance.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to World Championship Wrestling. I'm Tony Schiavone, along with the Rock and Roll Express. We'll be talking to you in just a second. First of all, a couple of bits of information for you. First of all, as you saw at the top of the program, the Four Horsemen have struck again, and this time it was Barry Windham who got into the ring, and all Four Horsemen jumped on him, as you saw. We'll be talking more about that. Vladimir Petrov, the Russian assassin, is back with us once again. He made a very awesome showing last week on this program, and also we are going to take a look about the Bunkhouse Stampede and about the Bunkhouse Champion and talk to Mr. Jim Crockett about that. But right here, the Rock and Roll Express, still not the World Tag Team Champions, but the fans think it won't be far away.
That's right, Tony. You know Rick Rude, Manny Fernandez, they go around calling themselves the R&R. Well, as far as Brother and I'm concerned, there's only one R&R right here, and that's the Rock and Roll Express. So guys, whenever you get enough nerve to put them titles back on the line, baby, Brother and I will be there.
That's right, Tony. They come out here and talk about all the things that they've got, the belts they're sitting on top of the mountains. But remember one thing, Paul Jones, Manny Fernandez, and Rick Rude, you don't have all these nice people out here, baby, standing behind you, pulling you through thick and thin, baby, because they know what it's about. They know that in 1987, the Rock and Roll Express, the real R&R, will have those World Tag Team belts running on their waist. So don't you forget it, baby. Never by Big Crew. We got to go. All right.
All right. The Rock and Roll Express. We're ready for our first event. The one and only gorgeous Jimmy Garvin against Keith Vincent in this event on World Championship Wrestling. Good to have you with us, and we got a great 2 hours for you today. Scrappy McGowan, the official, and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, a man who, well, when we talk to him, he talks a lot about Brad Armstrong and about Brad's father, Bob Armstrong. And an incident we saw this program some weeks ago, where Bob, as we take a look at Precious cheering her man on, Bob Armstrong came out here to say hello to his son, and then gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and superstar Bill Dundee got involved with a can, and a great tag team event took place right after that. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, all the glitter. And what an entrance he has. There's his leg. It's obvious he thinks he can do no wrong and can beat anyone at all. And right now, doing a very good job on the head of Keith Vincent. Also here today, the world champion Ric Flair, the world team champion Tully Blanchard, Brad Armstrong, Barry Windham, Jim Cornette and Big Bubba, Nikita Koloff and Dusty Rhodes, the Rock and Roll Express in action, and many others. Like we said, Vladimir Petrov, Captain Redneck, Dick Murdoch, and many others. Vincent trying to match him with power there. Vincent, a big boy. Big upper body, as you can see, but a big knee, that'll put anybody down. Garvin again with that left knee. Head right to the turnbuckle. Head right to the midsection. We talked about superstar Bill Dundee and being involved in that incident with the Armstrong. We're gonna be talking to the superstar a little bit later on in the program, and he has some bragging he is going to do. We know, and we'll just let him talk about it when he gets out here. It'll be in just a few minutes. Jimmy Garvin with that front face lock now. Talking to Precious and reassuring her confidence. I don't know what she did that for, but she does that all the time. You know, they demand when they're in the arenas that there'll be no smoking while he's wrestling. It gets in his hair, so they say. Right forearm. That time right to the top of the head. Vincent really dazed. Now Garvin will pick him up. It's a big boy to pick up like that and slam real hard. Gorgeous Jimmy. Stomping away. And once again, Vincent. Very strong. But we're looking at a veteran right here in Garvin. Many years in the ring. Many successful years in the ring. Vincent trying to fight back a little bit. And once again, Garvin takes him down. Superstar Bill Dundee in action today. Jimmy Garvin right now. Hooking him under. Brainbuster. Oh, that was devastating. There's your winner, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, and Precious quickly gets into the ring as her man wins again. And here he is. He is a new Central States Heavyweight Champion.
You hear all them rednecks over there yelling for that long drink of water? Well, I told you, boy, it was just a matter of time. You put this on the line, and I was going to beat you, Jack. Now, I would have beat him the night of the tournament, but I had a temperature that was 176 degrees. That would kill a normal man, but I ain't normal, Daddy. Now, I got to take my hat off to Jim Crockett. You know, he called me up. He said, superstar, superstar. I never liked the name on the side of that plane. Can I change it to the superstar? So he crossed that stardust, and he put superstar, because I got a belt, and you don't, Rhodes. Ha, ha, ha. Now, nobody took me serious for 3 months. I asked for opponents and nobody wanted to wrestle me. All of a sudden, because I beat Houston, Brad Armstrong wants to wrestle me. Dave Peterson wants to wrestle me up there in the Central States. Todd Champion, the Italian Stallion, and the list goes on and on and on. Well, Daddy, and I got another phone call. The weatherman calls up. He says, in Wichita, Salida, it's snowing and everybody's miserable. Well, you ain't going to be miserable no more, because I'm coming to see you Monday and Tuesday, Daddy. Yes, me, the Central States Champion. And I told you, didn't I tell you? Now, you hear that? They're calling for a loser, because that's what you are, loser. You're a loser, Houston. And he's so embarrassed that he run away after I beat him. You'll never see that long drink of water around here no more, because he's so embarrassed. Now, Dusty Rhodes, I told you, Jack, you come out one day and said I was a little munchkin and you was going to put me in the microwave and just go poof. Well, I didn't go poof, Daddy. I went on to bigger and better things. This belt. Come on, Rhodes. Thank you.
Okay, superstar Bill Dundee talking about the competitors for that Central States title, including, you know, a man who liked to get his hands on it. We're talking about Brad Armstrong. He'll be coming up later on, and we're coming back to talk about a bunkhouse champion, possibly, right after this. Jim Cornette, his Midnight Express and Big Bobby.
Oh,
you
yeah.
seem like you're celebrating
yeah,
about something.
Celebrating.
What's going on?
We had a big party in the back because, you see, besides the fact that Midnight Express is the greatest tag team in wrestling, all the good things that they're fixed to do, Big Bubba Rogers, just like I told everybody, is the Bunkhouse Stampede Champion. They've come
wait
and gone.
Minute,
and Big, just
wait,
shut
wait
up a second. I told you he was the baddest man in the world. I told you he could whip everybody. Dusty Rhodes, the Road Wars. Ain't nobody in the world tougher than my man Big Bubba Rogers, Bunkhouse Champion. I want a check for $100,000.
The fact is,
I want that big bronze boot. I want everything coming
Jimmy,
at
the
it.
Fact
what?
Is, he and Dusty Rhodes ended up in a virtual tie as far as number of Bunkhouse Stampede
wins. Hey, no, it don't matter whether it's a tie or not, because Big Bubba won more money. He won that big 100 grand jackpot Bunkhouse, and that means
okay.
He's $75,000 ahead.
Okay.
He's won more money.
Jimmy Crockett is here to help clarify
check.
Something.
You better have a boot, and you better give it to my man right now.
I have a check, and I have the boot.
Okay.
But there's no name on them yet, because Dusty Rhodes and Big Bubba won the same number of stampedes.
He won more money. He's 75 grand ahead. And believe
Rhodes,
me, we've been making good use of it.
You are the man that wins the most stampedes. And we have one way to settle it. We're going to have a match. Dusty Rhodes has already signed the contract. We're going to have a match on February the 27th in Pittsburgh in the Civic Arena. Big Bubba against Dusty Rhodes, if you want to sign the contract. In a cage, and the only way to win it is to throw the man over the top or out.
Wait a minute. What you saying to me, what you're saying to all the people is a cage match, Dusty and Bubba one-on-one in Pittsburgh. The winner is the guy who throws his opponent out over the top of the cage through the door, maybe even right straight through the wire.
That's correct.
Heather, you got a pen. Where's that contract? You got a pen? Come here. All I got to say is, yeah, don't worry about that envelope. All I got to say is what you better do is you better give me the interest on that money, because February 27 is still a ways away, and believe me, there would have been a lot of interest on $100,000, but the boot and the money is coming to Big Bubba Rogers, because he's the rightful champion right now, and Dusty's going to get taken out, brother. You better believe it. Come on, guys. Let's
February the 27th, we will know who the winner is.
And fans, there we have it. To decide the Bunkhouse Champion in a cage on the 27th of February in Pittsburgh at the Civic Arena, Dusty Rhodes and Big Bubba for the Bunkhouse Championship. What an event to be coming up in Pittsburgh. Let's go to the ring. In the ring, Brad Armstrong against Tommy Angel in this event. And before the match gets underway, I want to remind you of a time change of our Sunday night program, our World Championship Wrestling Sunday edition. Now comes your way at 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time right here on the Superstation. 1 hour, 5:30 to 6:30 right here on the Superstation. That's World Championship Wrestling Sunday edition beginning tomorrow night. Don't you miss it. Up with the arm, Brad Armstrong against Tom Angel. Then Armstrong going right to work on the arm. We saw at the first of the program, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and his abilities. He's had his problems with Brad Armstrong. And, well, it could be said the same about Brad having problems with not only gorgeous Jimmy, but superstar Bill Dundee and Precious as well. Armstrong would not let go of that headlock. Look, right back up with it. We talked right before the break to the Central States heavyweight champion, Bill Dundee, and we mentioned that Brad Armstrong is certainly a contender for that title. A little bit later on, we'll be seeing the Central States champion in action. To the rope. Good tackle by Armstrong. And right on top of him. Maybe that time he thought he could surprise Angel. Did not hook the leg, but almost. Still got the pin. Got a two count out of it. And back up with the left arm again. In the ropes. Angel tried to throw him off, and Armstrong held on again. Now the knee hard on that left arm. Well, as many great wrestlers will do, Brad Armstrong working on one part of the body. Angel trying to fight back. Armstrong with a big shoulder. Irish carry, great takedown. Well, Brad comes from a rich wrestling background. His father, who was here not that long ago, we've talked about that. I understand his father will be coming back soon, according to Brad. So we look forward to that. Good reversal by Angel. Armstrong. Great takedown. Right behind, took him down. Leg takedown that time. And right now, Angel may just want to try to get to the ropes, because we've seen some great ability from Tommy Angel as far as amateur background moves and things such as that. But everything he's done, Brad has been able to counter. Up with the headlock, take down again, and once again to the arm. Brad Armstrong is so far looking good in this match. Lifts him up high for a backdrop. We'll be talking to Barry Windham a little bit later on also, fans, and we'll talk about what happened with Barry and the Four Horsemen, all four of them. Actually, when you count J.J. Dillon, all five of them. And then also we'll be seeing in action once again a man who really made a big name for himself nationwide here last week, Vladimir Petrov. A man who already has an established name in the Kremlin. Armstrong! Good! Hip toss to get out of that. And Angel kicks out. Once again, a takedown. And right up with the arm again. We mentioned about Petrov last week and how Nikita was demanded out here by Ivan. And how nothing really happened then between Nikita and Petrov, but sooner or later, more than likely sooner, it is going to happen between these two Russian strongmen. Right to the ropes. Great dropkick. He leveled him with that. And now Armstrong grabs him with the neck, breaker from behind, got him over. Great move. There's your win. Brad Armstrong. Back to the ring. Central States heavyweight champion, a man we talked to early in the program, superstar Bill Dundee, going up against Randy Barber in this event. Well, and as we talked about, we saw what happened to Windham. The Four Horsemen again teaming up. Barber, good hip toss to get on Dundee, but it's close to the ropes. And Dundee wants timeout. He's calling about pulling the trucks. Dundee goes right for the legs. Quickness. Bill Dundee certainly is quick. Great wrestler. Considered Australia's greatest athlete out of Melbourne. And you're talking about confidence. Boy, he's loaded with it. Up on the left arm now. And now that superstar Bill Dundee has that Central States heavyweight title around his waist, you can better believe you're talking about one of the more prestigious titles in the country. A lot of men will be coming after that, such as Brad Armstrong. He talked about him, the American dream, Dusty Rhodes. He mentioned Dusty in his interview. A lot of top competition for that title. Once you get it, once you get the title, then you're the hunted. Then you're the man they're all after. And right now it's Dundee. Great dropkick. And Barber kicked out of it. Broke on the count. And again, the men tie up. Dundee, aggressive, stays on the offense. We're going to be talking to the world champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, a little bit later on. The Road Warriors are here today, the Legion of Doom. Boy, that'll make you mad. And it really made Randy Barber mad. So Dundee ties himself up in the ropes. Also here, the Russian assassin, the big red machine, Vladimir Petrov. Once again, Dundee smacks Randy Barber on the head. And Barber really losing his cool now. And as Dundee looks at the crowd really on him. Listen to him. Crossed him up that time. Looked like he's going to lock up, but he went for the legs. And as he tied up with some sort of a, almost like a spinning toe hold right there. Pulling down that leg, a Barber, that left leg. Smacks him again on the head. This is intimidation. This is to get your opponent flustered, upset, and Dundee is doing just that. Look at him. Bill Dundee. Actually, even though he's run to the ropes a couple of times to get out of there, he has maintained control in this match from the outset, and now with some spring out of the ropes, Dundee, oh, what a move. One count, I think he let the man kick out. He wants to beat him up some more. Smacks him again on the head. Barber is really beside himself. Bill Dundee, right on the head. Now Dundee outside, climbing up top. The knee on top of the head of Randy Barber. Bill Dundee will get the win. There's your winner, Central States Heavyweight Champion. And he looked pretty good in this match, very good in this match.
I know what you're gonna say, Tony. You're gonna say, where's the Midnight Express today? Well, they've been called in on a very important police case. It seems like this guy sneaked into a supply store and stole 25 toilet seats, and the police are baffled. They got nothing to go on. But don't worry, they're gonna be in Philadelphia tonight as we speak. The scaffold is going up on the floor of that Philadelphia Civic Center for the Night of the Skywalkers and Road Wars. We're gonna prove to you once and for all just exactly how bogus you really are. You're not the toughest men in the world. What you are is a couple of muscle-bound clowns that's gonna get thumped off that scaffold, and if it don't happen tonight in Philadelphia, and there's always Los Angeles, California, a lot of weird people out there, well, they're gonna see a weird thing, the most awesome, most dangerous thing in wrestling, a scaffold match, 25 feet in the air, Midnight Express and the Road Wars. And I heard earlier, you replayed that little videotape of me and old tightwad Jim Crockett Jr. got those pockets that sewn shut, won't come up with that check for $100,000 that my man Big Bubba rightfully won, because he is the Bunkhouse Stampede champion. Night after night after night in those Bunkhouse Stampedes, he got in the ring with 25 other men, and he threw one this way and one that way until they were all out of the picture. He won more Bunkhouse Stampedes than Road Warrior Hawk or Road Warrior Animal or Nikita Koloff, Dick Murdoch, on down the line. Won more Bunkhouse Stampedes than anybody but Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. But he's still the Bunkhouse Champion because he won more money. No. He won that $100,000. Yes,
no,
he did.
That's not
he
in the
won
rules.
More money. He won that big $100,000 jackpot stampede in Atlanta,
that's
and
right.
That means he's $75,000 hit, yes or no? 75 grand
okay,
a hit.
He's 75.
He won more money. Well, what do you get in a match like that for except to win money? That's exactly what the reason is. So let me tell you something, Dusty Rhodes, and you, Jim Crockett. Pittsburgh, the 27th of February, gonna have a showdown one-on-one in a cage for the bronze boot and the 100 grand. And believe me, Dusty Rhodes, if he has to throw you through the door of the cage, over the top of the cage, or through the wire, he's gonna do it. And Crockett, you better come up with that check. He didn't want to give me a check because he knows if he pays Dusty at 100 grand, he'll let him pay it in installments of 5,000 bucks or something. I'll see you later.
Okay, fans, we'll talk to Dusty Rhodes right after this timeout. And here he is, fans, a chance to win your second straight Bunkhouse Championship, Dusty, coming up in February.
Mr. Crockett laid it on the line. Pittsburgh, Civic Arena, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and Big Bubba, steel cage. Jim Cornette said you can take a man's hand and actually fit it through the steel on the cage. Big Bubba, you know, when he go through like this, and if he loses breath, you can't pull him back through. You can't pull him back through. You know what I mean, baby? Woo, Saturday night, and I'm hot. My man Nikita getting ready to do business. Throughout the country, all around the world now, I see millions of signs saying, this is getting funky like a monkey tour, 1987. Dusty Rhodes, American Dream, Tully Blanchard, Ole Iron, Nature Boy Ric Flair, American Dream, is beside it. You think you're messing with Trump change? You ain't messing with Chuck Chase. You messing with the big money. And Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream here. So wherever the land gonna take us in this year, 1987, get in here.
Tony Schiavone, Dusty Rhodes, and Magnum gonna be there. Ric Flair can come out here looking as clean as it won't. Say hello to my brother in Colorado. Say hello to my mother in Houston, Texas. Say hello to my babies down in North Carolina. Because the American Dream's here in 87, it's gonna be hot, and this is getting ready to be funky like a monkey to 1987.
All right, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, let's go to the ring. The other half of the superpowers, U.S. champion Nikita Koloff against Larry Stevens. Knowing in the back of his mind that Vladimir Petrov is here once again today. Stevens trying maybe to take Nikita over for a suplex. Koloff! A suplex of his own. And Nikita! And he bounces up and is poised for the sickle. Listen to the fans, here it comes. That's it. That is it. Nikita Koloff, your winner. Not only does Alan Martin get a chance to win a title here on Nationwide TV, but he's got a chance in 25 minutes with that time limit to win $10,000. Tully presented the referee with that money bag. Handshake as Blanchard the champion and Martin the challenger. Now you notice, good takedown by Blanchard. James J. Dillon not at ringside with Tully to hang on to that belt of that money. But we understand Mr. Dillon is in a meeting at this time with Mr. Jeff Crockett about what we're not sure of as Blanchard continues his assault on Martin. And we understand that JJ will be going on tonight to Philadelphia to get ready for that event and that title defense. Right by the hair, Blanchard. Right up against the ropes. Call it a break, got it right on the count. Blanchard, right hand of the midsection. Now pulling at the jaw and the face. Blanchard again, got him up to the turnbuckle. Left and right. Snapmare. Blanchard feeling good, and so far in this match, he's looking great. Martin trying to climb to his feet. Blanchard had slapped him in the face, and now that time a right hand of the jaw. Tully just doing everything he can to hurt Martin, and everything he's doing is working. Grabbing at the face now again of Alan Martin. That pressure not only on the jaw, but the neck muscles. Elbow to the top of the head. World Television Championship, and there's a lot of people out there who would like that and that $10,000, including Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Barry Windham, who we talked to earlier, and who was the recipient of that slingshot after all the horsemen beat him in the ring. And Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch, who, as everybody knows, is a man certainly capable of winning that title. And Blanchard knows this as well. And Blanchard right now upset that right hand didn't face him. Martin's man. Alan Martin, right hands up against the turnbuckle. Another one. Blanchard may be in a little bit of trouble here. Enough trouble to make you mad. Right hand to the jaw again, a warning from Scrappy McGowan. Azeem Hook, there's your slingshot. Right on target. And there's your winner. Still the World TV Champion. Still $10,000 in his pocket.
Do it! Nikita Koloff! Yeah! You, Nikita! Oh, let's talk about Nikita. You, my friend, live somewhere outside of this earth. Because, Nikita, if you think that you get on TV and go like this and then beat me, you're sadly mistaken. And I don't care if it's Philadelphia tonight, Charlotte, North Carolina, Atlanta, Georgia, Los Angeles, Odessa. You, my friend, are going to have to be more man than you've ever been in your entire life. Don't wrap me up yet, buddy. Now, Dusty Rhodes, funky like a monkey. Well, let me say hi to Mama Rhodes. Let me say hi to the family here. Folks, so sorry to tell you this. Dusty Rhodes, this year is no longer the man in the sport you're looking at, brother. Big Dust, whether you like it or not, the big man's taking over.
The world champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair. Woo! We're coming right back. Don't you dare go away. Here he is, fans, still the world television champion, still with $10,000.
What's the back of that shirt say?
It says Horseman. Remember
that's
the four.
Where it is. The Four Horsemen, 1987. That's Ric Flair, the world's heavyweight champion. Tully Blanchard, world's television champion. Ole Anderson and Arn Anderson. And make no qualms about it, no mistake. All four equal in ability. And you know, there's even one that may have gone through a harder road than anybody. The Rock, you know, he came from a poor, poor town in Minnesota. Sat in a bar working for his mom and dad upstairs having to sweep all night long. The Rock has been in a lot of barroom brawls, and he may be the toughest of them all. So don't ever underestimate him. But you know, Tony Schiavone, you talk about, you saw me beat a guy here in just a minute at will. James J. Dillon, you know, he's been in a big meeting with Jim Crockett. And he's on his way to Philadelphia. That's why he's not here today, to get ready for tonight's festivities after the Night of the Skywalkers. And you know, Dusty Rhodes, Philadelphia, it's you and me for the world's television title, the one I took from you. But you know, Big Dust, the $10,000 right here, just like I've always said, I dictate the rules. But you know, these $10,000 bills, you know, Big Dust, I haven't quite decided whether I should bring these to the ring tonight or not, you know? But by then, James J. and I will have our game plan down. And you know, Big Dust, I may bring them, I may not. I dictate the rules, but there's one thing for sure. I'm gonna walk the aisle, and I'm gonna bring this with me. Right here, the world's television title. But you know, you think back about last week, Tim Horner, great, great wrestler, great competitor, tough, tough match. At no point did I think that I was in jeopardy of losing, but it was tough, and he was hard to defeat. Barry Windham over here trying to give us his expert commentary. But you know, an imitation of Barry Windham was, God, he cheated. Let me go do something. And then a couple minutes later, it's bam, 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 and this is Barry Windham laying here like this, looking up at me. No more Horsemen. Don't do it to me anymore. That's you, Barry Windham. That's what you looked like last week on national television at the hands of me and the Four Horsemen. So, Barry Windham, you think about it. You take it back to Dusty Rhodes and Dick Murdoch, and you go tell all your friends, the Horsemen did it to me. Ronnie Garvin, you talk about what we did to you and the broken legs. You talk about everything the Horsemen have done over the last 2 years. And that's right.
We're the baddest there is. If you want to sneak up on people, we can sneak up better than anybody. If you want to look at us across the ring, eyeball to eyeball, we can do that better than anybody. That's why we've got these to prove it. That's why we are the Four Horsemen.
Charlie Blanchard. Getting to the ring, here they are, the fan favorites, the Rock and Roll Express against Allen West and Andy Roberts. Roberts wanted to go up top, but Gibson right down with the stomach drop. And an arm drag up with an arm. Still after the World Tag Team title held by a team and a team that is held on now to the World Tag Team title for quite a while. We're talking about the Raging Bull, Ravishing Rick Rude with Paul Jones. I think most people thought that that would be a team that wouldn't hold on to the title for any length of time, but boy, those two men have proved everybody wrong. And you're talking about some bad feelings between two teams. Martin takes down West. The chant of rock and roll as we hear so many places at World Championship Wrestling goes. Fans, I want to remind you very briefly that World Championship Wrestling Sunday Edition has a new time, 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time. At 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time, right here on the Superstation. So join us tomorrow night for World Championship Wrestling Sunday Edition with our new time at 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Eddie Roberts. Robert Gibson kicks out. Got a two count out of that. Roberts jumps back up right. Eyeball up with Robert Gibson. Fans, we have another 4 hour of World Championship Wrestling coming your way. And we'll have that in this match right after this timeout. Back with you now on the World Championship Wrestling for our second hour. I'm Tony Schiavone. Glad to have you with us. And we're starting out as hot as we left you with our second hour as this match continues as the Rock and Roll Express take on Roberts and West. And Eddie Roberts tags Allen West. And West and Roberts, both young, good-looking men. But when you talk about firepower, you're talking about the Rock and Roll Express, and there's an example. How many big men have Ricky Morton taken down? Tag to Gibson. In this hour of World Championship Wrestling, the Road Warriors, Captain Nick, Dick Burdock, U.S. Tag Team Champions, Wyndham and Garvin, Vladimir Pietro, Ivan Koa, and many other top stars. Back to the corner again. Right hand to the chest. Teamwork at its best right here. Belly to back suplex. One thing about Paul Jones, he has Those two men, the Raging Bull and Rick Rude, at a great level right now. There you see Ricky Morton calling for the Raging Bull. You know, when they won the World Tag Team title right here on Nationwide TV, it was a case of working on the injuries of Morton and Gibson. Well, those injuries have healed now, so it's a lot different. West moving Gibson back to the corner nearest us and shoots him across the other way. Gibson with a great tackle. Now slam. Eddie Roberts seems to be upset as what's going on. Jumps in very quickly. Now Ricky Morton. Again, fans, we're looking at one fine tag team. And a team that is growing in popularity day by day. Their new fan club. Both Ricky and Robert have remarked to me that they are very pleased and happy about the numbers running their fan club. Hey, Tony, you want to make a wish? Ricky Morton. That time, right on the thighs of Eddie Roberts. Fans, we are watching right now the way a tag team event and a tag team championship caliber team is supposed to wrestle. And you hear rock and roll again. Gibson still holding onto that leg. And now the tag to Ricky Morton. Good move by Eddie Roberts getting to his corner, and now West with a quick roll up. How did a two count that time? Allen West. Almost slipped in there. But as much as anything else, the ability to take punishment and to still come out winning has always been one of the strong points for the Express. And Morton now fighting back. Eddie Roberts got in. He's in the wrong corner to be. The tag is made to Robert Gibson. Of a dropkick. Didn't take him long to decide that. The Rock and Roll Express winner. What was a very good match. We're with Captain Redneck. Dick Murdoch talked about all the cities you'll be in, including like Columbus, Georgia.
Well, that's right. You know, Tony, Columbus, Georgia, and Fred Ward, he's always been a great promoter. There's going to be great matches down there next Friday night. Baron Von Rush is going to be there. Manny Fernandez, Rick Rude. It's going to be big, exciting matches. And Jim Crockett Promotions, you know, they never fail to cease to amaze me. All the huge crowds that were drawn all over the country, I mean, it's just great to be part of that, Tony. You know, starting here and heading on out west. You know, we just left Amarillo, Texas, where it was jam-packed Civic Center of pandemonium and mayhem, and we had a little hootenanny, a little party out at my place, and all the kids, everybody really liked the Road Warriors, and Dusty and Nikita really got over those sheriff hooks out there, and we had a heck of a time. And then California, L.A., Frisco, San Francisco, packed, jam-packed to the rafters, baby. And now that John Ayers, my old buddy, plays for 49ers, ended his season a little bit early. John, you get the rest of the team to come on out and watch us, the real winners of the world of professional wrestling. And in Odessa, like I said, it's going to be big, Tony. It's going to be big. And one other thing, I heard Tully Blanchard standing out here talking about how tough he is and that he is the world's TV champion. He is. but he's got $10,000 waving around it. Nobody can beat him. Well, Blanchard, I want you to go ahead and talk to Jim Dillon and ask that man how about a beating I'll give him a few years ago. I won't, Tully Blanchard. I want that $10,000 because I'm showing a horse around the country, me and Leroy Webb, and we could take that $10,000 and sure haul that horse a lot of miles, and Janet can sure fix a lot more brisket out there on OJ&D, and we could have a heck of a hoot down in Hootenanny. So, Tully, anytime you want to put your name on that contract, I'll be more than happy to put mine across the bottom of it, and we'll go for it. You know, there's great competitors, Tony, great competitors here.
And it's not only the $10,000, it's the chance of being the World TV champion.
Well, you know, that's a great stepping stone until getting a shot at Ric Flair. You know, I've wrestled Ric before, the World's Heavyweight Champion, and if you win that World's TV title, it puts you right in line for the World's Heavyweight Championship. And doggone it, Ric Flair is one heck of a champion. He's one of the greatest champions I've ever laid eyes on. I've seen a lot of them. Ric, if I can ever beat Tully Blanchard, which I think I can do, and down in my heart I know I can do it, then I want a shot at Ric Flair. But you know, there's a lot of people in line for that too. Nikita, Dusty Rhodes. I mean, even Manny Fernandez, Rick Rude, people like that, Jimmy Garvin, Ronnie Garvin would like a shot at Ric Flair. I mean, it just doesn't have to be somebody like Rhodes or myself or Nikita or anybody like that. Anybody wants that World Heavyweight Championship belt, and that's the greatest thing in the world today. It's like winning a Super Bowl in professional football. And, Tony, one day I hope I can do it.
Okay, Captain Redneck, Dick Brock, good to see you, Captain.
Thank you.
Always good seeing you.
Man.
All right, we're going right back to the ring. They're here. Hawk and Animal with Precious Paul, the Road Warriors. We could just sit back and watch somebody getting beat up at the best. Ray Aaron, David Isley, and Ray Aaron getting pretty bad right now. Tag, David Isley. Look at the size difference here.
Tell him, big man. You know something, Tony Schiavone? For the last 4 years,
The Warriors have come out here and told everybody in the stinking United States what we were going to do. Then we did it. We're not out here like Manny Fernandez and Rick Rude. Saying we're a couple of bad guys. We're going to kick everybody's tail in because they can't get the job done. When Hawk and myself, when we designed to take the world championships, we'll do it and nothing will stop us. Flair, the Four Horsemen, we ain't done with you yet. Is anybody in the AWA that wants to find out if we've got soft, you can take us in tags or with our brother, Dusty Rhodes, for the six-man championship and just see if you're bad enough to beat the Legion of
Tony Schiavone, I hope Jimmy Cornette is good at catching dirt balls because he's going to have to catch a couple of dirt balls. And every scaffold match we ever wrestle the Midnight Express in, he better get his dirt ball men out and catch his dirt balls. Because the Warriors are coming to town, and that's good for some people and bad for others.
Tony Schiavone, we may sound like bitter men out here, but then again, medicine usually is bitter. There's a lot of wrestlers out there that want to know where we've been. Well, you know where we've been. We've been to Hereford, Texas. Now you want to know where we're going? Well, we're going to go to Hollywood, and it's not Hollywood, California. Hollywood, Florida. We're coming to Hollywood, Florida. We're coming to Los Angeles. We're going to raise the scaffold. So you walk around, and you're thinking to yourself, boy, this mind isn't clogged up. The reason it's not clogged up is because there's no facts in it. The fact of the matter is, when you face the Legion of Doom, you face the best. One more thing. Tony, why walk around dead when you can be buried for $22?
The Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors. Let's go to the ring. U.S. Tag Team Champions Barry Windham and Ryan Garvin against Randy and Bill Mulkey. Fans, another reminder to you that tomorrow night, our Sunday edition of World Championship Wrestling comes your way at 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time, a new time that each and every week you can see our Sunday edition of World Championship Wrestling for 1 hour, 5:30 to 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time, right here on the Superstation. Join us tomorrow night. Barry Windham in against Randy Mulkey. A lot of things have happened to these two men, but they are still U.S. Tag Team Champions and looking better each and every week. Fans, before we get underway this match, reminder, coming up next, Vladimir Petrov. As Garvin rolls Randy Mulkey right towards the ropes and now pulling on Mulkey. Look at that, the pressure not on the chin, not only on the chin, but also on the legs. The shins crisscross right there. Oh, got a one count, but shoulders not down. Almost got it that time. Garvin with Windham on the outside. There's a tag to Barry. Big right hand on the chest. Big man, Sweetwater, Texas. Windham and Garvin, and think of the list of challengers for the U.S. Tag Team title. Notably, the Road Warriors are and the Midnight Express and the Andersons. They're all out there, the greatest teams in the world. There. Speaking of tag team competition, coming up in April 10th and 11th, two nights. Two-day tournament for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament. And that'll be held at Baltimore Arena. And you're in the tournament only by invitation. So think about all the great tag teams who will be entered in that one. Road Warriors, defending champion. Right hand by Garvin. Ronnie Garvin picks him up again. Headbutt. Rakes him across the back. Picks up Bill Mulkey to slap him down again. This is a case of pick him up to knock him down again. And Ronnie Garvin destroying Bill Mulkey. Look at him grabbing him right on the back. Barry's up on top now. Drop kick. Something for a man that big to get that high on a drop kick, and Windham casually drops right down on Bill Mulkey. U.S. Tag Team Champions. Another team. Think about it. Ivan Koloff, Vladimir Pietrov. That'll be looking to get their hands on the U.S. title, tag team title. Big uppercut. Not only that, and we talked about tag team situations for these men, but they're also great singles wrestlers. And members of the Four Horsemen, notably Tully Blanchard in that world TV title in $10,000. And also Ric Flair. We say should be on the lookout for these two, but you know they are. As Garvin has had a great match with Flair, so has Windham. And Tully's got that incentive with the money. And speaking of a setup, just last week when the Horsemen jumped on Barry Windham, what more incentive can you want? Garvin. A good look at Ronnie Garvin as he puts the pressure on Bill Mulkey. Slapping him on the back. Whelps on his back already. Uh-oh. Pulling and twisting Bill Mulkey. Gotta hurt. You can see it hurt. It hurts looking at it. Now Garvin stopping on one foot, pulling on the other. Fix him up. For a backslide. And Bill Mulkey. Being absolutely beat to pieces. We have seen Randy and Bill Mulkey take a beating before, but I don't think anyone's beat him up like this in a long time. Right hand uppercut. Tagged to Ronnie Garvin, Windham will shoot him across. High backdrop. Tag again to Windham. Another great win. Fans, we're back with you at ringside, and what action we have seen so far here today on the Superstation. Right now with us, the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff. We've already seen Vladimir Pietrov, and you're going to show us a tape of the awesome power.
There's old Russian saying that a picture is worth a thousand words. Well, Vladimir is a picture that is worth a billion words. Anybody that's not afraid of Vladimir is either crazy or stupid or both. And Nikita, I know you're afraid. I know you're afraid because Vladimir is here. You say if you need any assistance, you will call on the great American dream, Dusty Rhodes, and his friends. Well, quit hiding, Nikita. Come out like a man and face Vladimir one-on-one in ring. I want you to look at this, Nikita, very close. This VTR, what's going to happen to you is exactly what happened to this American here, sent to the hospital with injuries to his neck.
Okay, let's take a look, Ivan, at what happened. And we're going to take a look at a young man, Tony Zane, being beat all over the ring. But right at the end, it's really, watch, you're going to come in and get rid of the referee.
This is right. Obviously, the official was off for the other man and trying not to see what he was doing, breaking rules. Now you see this man is already beaten. He cannot stand up. But Vladimir is going to show everybody, give them an example, especially Nikita, exactly what is going to happen to him. He is carted out after this to the hospital with a very serious injury to the neck, I understand. Too bad for him. He signed a contract to get in the ring. At least he had guts enough to do that. Like Nikita hiding behind Dusty Rhodes. Well, Nikita, you cannot hide forever. Come out like a man and take your medicine. You said before that you are going to have to take your punishment for what you did to your country. It is one thing what you have done to the family. But when you do this to the country, Nikita, you will be punished. And Vladimir is waiting for you, Nikita. 300 pounds, 6'4". He's going to put you down just like he put this American down. And Dusty Rhodes, if you don't like it, great protector of Nikita, all the American fans are not going to be able to help him. All their cheers is not going to be helping Nikita one bit. Even though I know they all stand behind him. It's like a victory to the American people now that Nikita has defected. But Nikita, you will never be world champion. Nikita, you are going down at the hands of Vladimir.
And let's take a look at the Russian assassin. Against two men, Vladimir Petrov. 300 plus pounds steel. Throwing both George South and Vernon Deaton down, and now just poised to get them both with the Russian sickle. Methodical, just like a cat waiting. The hammer, Vernon Deaton's down. Pietro, under the command of Ivan, throwing men out of the ring. Both men go out, and there he is. Jim Cornette.
You didn't get enough of me the first time around. You know, I heard Precious Paul Ellering out here talking about that discount mortician he goes to. Bury somebody for $22. Well, what have I got right here, Tony Schiavone? Can you count that up real quick?
That looks like $66.
$66, $22 for Paul, $22 for Animal, $22 for Hulk. I might even give the guy a tip if he does a good job, because believe me, brother, you get up on that scaffold with the Midnight Express, you're gonna need this stuff right here. I don't need it, because I got plenty. And let me say something else about the Midnight Express. We're still looking for the United States Tag Team title. Everybody that watches this TV program knows a couple of weeks ago, right there in that ring, we would have been, don't try to sneak any of that away, we would have been the United States Tag Team Champions if we'd had 35 more seconds, because Ronnie Garvin was a beaten man, but he's so stupid, he didn't know when he was beat. Well, let me tell you something, Garvin. I intend on the Midnight Express being the United States Tag Team Champions going into that Crockett Cup Tag Team Tournament, and I don't like some nappy-headed, funny-looking punk standing in the way of what the Midnight Express wants. You know something? When people stand in the way of what Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express wants, that just kind of wheezes me off. So I tell you what I'm going to do, Garvin. I'm going to give you one more warning. Son, you better put those belts up real quick, and this time you better have a good sense to realize when you're overmatched, or elsewise we're going to take you completely out of the picture, Garvin. We're going to put an end to your career once and for all. We're going to get you out of here where people don't have to put up with your goofy looking face, where people don't have to put up with your goofy looking tactics in the ring, where people don't have to put up with you in general and that goofy partner you got, that long, tall, skinny, skunk-headed Barry Windham. Let me tell you something, boy. Don't you follow Ronnie Garvin's example. Don't you try to put up a fight against the Midnight Express when there ain't no use to it, or elsewise you're going to suffer the same fate. Everybody knows that there's nobody can beat the Midnight Express in a tag team match. We are, I promise America, going to be the United States Tag Team Champions. And Ronnie Garvin, you know as well as I do, when the hour of midnight falls, it's the darkest part of the night. But when midnight falls on you, Ronnie Garvin, it's going to be the darkest period in your life, son. You're going to wish that you'd never been born. You ain't going to be able to see no light at the end of that tunnel. All you're going to look down and see is no belt around your waist, if you can look down, or else there might be a neck brace on your neck preventing it, or elsewise there might be a body cast on your body preventing you from seeing that naked waist. But one way or another, Garvin, you're going to get taken out completely. We're going to have those belts and win them. I don't really know and don't really care what's going to happen to you. And Tony, when I get in the back, I'm going to count this, and if you've got any of it, I'm going to come back and I'm going to rifle your wallet till I get what's mine.
Fans, we'll be back right after this timeout. Back in the ring, Ivan Koloff going up against Zane Smith, and there's a look at Pietrov once again. Vladimir Pietrov, that's a big, big man. And now we're going to take a look at the man behind all of this. Ivan Koloff. In some ways, you know, we say Ivan's behind it, but you know there's orders from the top for Ivan and for Pietrov. And Ivan is just taking apart Zane Smith there early in this match. It's got to be the face of Zane Smith as Pietrov looks on. To the floor, and Ivan's got to go after him. Smith hit the concrete. And Pietrov. Watching on is Koloff. You know what has happened to Nikita, just grinds at the man. Grinds at him at all times. Tosses the man right down. And again. Koloff. Right over the corner of Pietrov. Yes! Pietrov with a big right hand in the head of Smith.
Come on, American.
Now Zane Smith with the right hand. And another one. But no match for that right forearm of Koloff. One thing on the mind of Ivan, possessing his thoughts, and that's Nikita, along with Dusty Rhodes. We saw him out here earlier. And Nikita is as awesome as ever. Ivan, as the intro watches, trying to insult the fans here at ringside as much as anything else. Grabbing Smith now by the trunks. Shoulders right to the back. Right boot. In the chest. Smith on the floor again. Pietrov over near him. There he is. Throws him right back in.
One, two, three, wrong.
Hook to the ropes, Ivan. Alive, away. And again.
Two, three, four,
five. Dumping away on Zane Smith. Warning, grabbing McGowan. And a belly-to-back suplex. This, as much as anything else right now, is a clinic from Ivan Koloff and how to destroy somebody. The veteran. He has been a world champion on many occasions, but that championships, titles do not concern Ivan Koloff right now. Fans, want to remind you as we take a look at Ivan Koloff to join us tomorrow night at our new time for our Sunday edition of World Championship Wrestling, 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's 5:30 p.m. Eastern Time right here on the Superstation. New time for World Championship Wrestling Sunday edition, 1 hour, and it all starts tomorrow night, 5:35 p.m. Eastern. Right hand. Koloff walking right across the chest.
What is the matter?
Still having something to say to the fans at ringside. And the man called the Russian Bear, assaulting Zane Smith. Your Russian hammer from Pietrov used, but that one's on the throat. And Scrappy McGowan calling Verbrink. Got one. Ivan S. Smith on the ropes. What's he gonna do here? Holding on the chin! And then dropping to the floor. Smith still reeling from that move. Off now with that big right hand. Right down on back of the head. We take a look at Pietrov looking on and watching and learning from a master. Ivan has Smith in the corner. Has by the hair. Oh my, no. Right, face first down with a knee in the back. Ivan Koloff. The Russian Bear. Awesome, awesome display by both Russians. Not only Pietrov just moments before, but Ivan Koloff, the Russian Bear, just minutes after. Both men are geared up and ready for only one thing, like we said, and it's gonna have to come to a head very soon against this man right here, the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff.
You know, I want to say something to him as well. Week after week after week, he come on and he look good, like he tell you. Inside, he feel good. And he should. He's the world heavyweight champion. Rafael, you know I'm this far from defeating you for world heavyweight title. Soon, you're going to be looking for me. Now, Vladimir Pietrov. Okay, you made your move. You come into Nikita life. Ivan Koloff bringing you back. Ivan Koloff, he teach you. He teach you, I see, to hurt people. You want to hurt somebody? Take a look at this, Vladimir. Take a good look. Try and hurt Nikita Koloff. Try and hurt American Dream, the Zero. But do it to our face. Don't come from behind. Do it to our face. You got the gun. Show Nikita what kind of gun you got. You know what you're going to find out? You're going to find out. You know so bad. Jato, Vladimir. Get ya, Vladimir. Gato. You tell me. I be there, Vladimir.
Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff. Fans, back with more action right after this. We're back. Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch against Brody Chase. And the captain had a good time in that homecoming of his back in Amarillo. Better said, his wife had a real big party. And looking forward to going back to Texas, Odessa, Texas, the NWA coming your way. January 28th. The NWA, the major league, with such stars as Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch. He was out here earlier as he has Brody Chase in some bit of trouble right there. He talked about Tully Blanchard in that World TV title. And if the title itself wasn't incentive enough, then that $10,000. As Murdoch pulls onto the arm. Fans, want to remind you to mark this date on your calendar. It's Saturday, February 7th. That is Saturday, February the 7th. Something big, exciting, and special coming your way, and we'll have more information on it here on the Super Station in the weeks to come. Don't forget that date, Saturday, February the 7th. Mark it down on your calendar. Stay tuned to us right here on the Super Station. More information about that big date. Murdoch pulling at the arm of Brody Chase. Stomping away now at the chest. Good takeover. As you know, and Murdoch knows, that time limit on that World TV title is whatever Tully Blanchard says he can dictate. He's been saying now 25 minutes, but in reality, if he can do that, he can make it as long or as short as he'd like. Although now he's talking 25 minutes. Murdoch pulling on Chase, master of the brain buster. What a pro, what a veteran. As Murdoch continues to hold on to that arm. Nice coming here. Specific game plan on Brody Chase. And Dick Murdoch. Continues to punish away. Holding on. Chase going right back after him. Brody Chase, right hand to the head. Another one. And Brody Chase, shoulder blocks on Murdoch. A reversal. And now as he hooks, looks like the brain buster. There it was. Dick Murdoch, the win with the brain buster. There's your winner, Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch. The Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff, just an awesome display by both you men.
You know, Nikita, I know you're very proud of being United States heavyweight champion. All the American people look up to you, cheer you on in the arenas. Vladimir, that's all, just in there. But Nikita, you know, all the American people so proud of you defecting over to this country. It's like a moral accomplishment to them. But Nikita, stop and think for 1 minute. Now that you are number one contender to the world title, if I was to send Vladimir after U.S. title and take it away from you, that would be punishment in somewhat to you. But not enough, Nikita. First of all, we've got to be able to get you in the ring one-on-one against Vladimir. So far, you are not accepting this challenge. I think you are afraid. Matter of fact, I know you are afraid from things in the past. The competition that Vladimir gave you in the past. I know you think it's too much for you. That's why you're reluctant. Instead, you come out here and you say that we might attack you from behind. Don't you call us cowards, Nikita. You don't deserve any respect for what you have done to our country. And Vladimir feels the same way as I do about this. We are hurt deep inside. We will never forgive it. Even after your punishment, we will never forgive it. We have already disowned you. Now, Vladimir is going to destroy you altogether in wrestling.
See you tomorrow night at 5:30 on our Sunday edition show and next week on World Championship Wrestling.